Now we are going to discuss a very important topic, which is tumors of the ovary. First, the WHO classification of the ovary, and that this is divided into surface epithelial stromal tumors and then germ cell tumors and then sex cord tumors. I'll give you the WHO classification of tumors. You can see it, and later on you can go and see the books, and we go one by one. First, surface epithelial stromal tumors, and amongst that, serous tumors. Now, the serous tumor can be benign, borderline, or malignant. These are commonly cystic neoplasm, which are lined by tall columnar ciliated epithelium and are filled with serous fluid. The borderline, benign, and malignant types, they account for about 30% of all ovarian tumors. Only benign and borderline, they form about 70% of serous tumors. Malignant tumors are around 30%. Serous carcinomas, they account for approximately 40% of the cancers of the ovary and are the most malignant ovarian tumors. Benign and borderline tumors are most common between the ages of 20 and 45 years, whereas serous carcinomas, they are seen at a later age group. The cases where there is a positive family history, they are seen at an early age group. Benign serous tumors, now if we discuss their gross pathology, they are bilateral in about 10% of cases. They are called cystadenomas. Usually they have smooth, glistening, thin-walled cysts which are filled with clear, watery serous fluid, which may be mucinous or which may be sometimes hemorrhagic. Papillary cystadenoma, when we label this lesion, it means that the inner lining with small polypidal excrescences and an underlying cystic component. Surface papillomas, they are composed of coarse papillary projections on the surface of the outer surface of the ovary, and they are without any cystic cavity. Adenofibromas and cystadenofibromas are predominantly solid fibrous tumors with a variable number of fluid-filled glands or cysts and firm papillary excrescences. Histologically, serous neoplasm, their epithelium, they just mimic like that of the epithelium of the fallopian tube. Cysts, papillae, and glands, they are lined by mainly a single layer of cuboidal to low columnar epithelium, which is ciliated and without any significant nuclear atypia. But they can also be lined by non-ciliated cuboidal to columnar secretory epithelium. Now, due to the pressure effect of the accumulated serous fluid, the epithelium becomes flattened and the stroma, which is dense and fibrous, may become oedematous. Rarely seminoma bodies are present, and the variants include cystadenoma and papillary cystadenoma, surface papilloma, and adenofibroma and cystadenofibroma. Borderline serous tumors. The peak incidence of borderline serous tumor is seen between 30 to 60 years of age. They make about 10% of all serous tumors, 20 to 30% of them, they are bilateral, and the gross features, they are very similar to that of the benign serous tumors, or they have more excrescences on the surface. If they are in the form of cysts, they are lined by abundant, fine, somewhat firm papillary projections. Histological features of serous borderline tumor. In this case, we can see under microscope, there is increased complexity of the stromal papillae, and they show branching, and then there is stratification of the epithelium with mild nuclear atypia, but destructive infiltrative growth into the ovarian stroma is not present. At the same time, the cells, they have scanty cytoplasm, bland nuclei, they have moderate to abundant cytoplasm with round hyperchromatic nuclei and prominent nuclei. Seminoma bodies may or may not be present. Immunohistochemistry, well, weak or negative P53 excludes high-grade serous carcinoma, and WT1 is positive. Malignant serous tumors. They are most common malignant ovarian neoplasms, which are seen around the age of 40 to 70 years, and they constitute about 20 to 25% of all serous tumors. In this tumor, there is elevation of CA125, which is not very specific for serous tumors. However, it is still taken as one of the tumor markers for serous tumors, because in non-malignant conditions like pelvic inflammatory diseases, CA125 can be raised. Regarding the gross features, this malignant serous tumors, they are bilateral in about 70% of the cases. Well-differentiated forms are partly solid, but mostly cystic and papillary tumors. When they are cystic, they are called serous cyst adenocarcinoma. When they have got papillary structures, we call them as papillary serous cyst adenocarcinoma. They're all just histological feature. We are just coming to that. Surface serous carcinomas include large hemorrhagic papillary excrescences on the surface of the ovary. The poorly differentiated tumors show solid areas with areas of hemorrhages, necrosis, and papillary structures can be demonstrated. Moreover, poorly differentiated tumors show more solid areas which are friable, necrotic, hemorrhagic, and only few recognizable papillae are seen. Tumor adhesions to the adjacent structure is common. Now, the histological features, we see that the tumors are very cellular and they show invasion of the ovarian stroma. High-grade tumors, which are grade 2 or 3, contain very few papillary. Mostly they are composed of solid sheets of cells with pleomorphic nuclei, hyperchromatic nuclei, and atypical mitosis. They are also present. There is cellular budding and stratification. Well-differentiated tumors are low-grade tumors. The pattern is mostly the micropapillary, and these papillary, they are non-branching, rather they are lace-like with low-grade nuclei. Smoma bodies are present in most of the well-differentiated tumors, and if they are prominent, then the tumor is called smoma carcinoma. Regarding the immunohistochemistry, vimentin positive, CA125 positive, more than 60% of the high-grade tumor and less than 10% of the low-grade tumor show positivity for P53 and WT1 positive. Risk factors and molecular genetics, nulliparity, family history, heritable mutations, they all play part in the development of the tumor. Gonadal dysgenesis in the children is associated with the high risk of developing ovarian carcinoma. Females who at the age of 40 to 60 taking oral contraceptives or undergo tubal ligation have reduced risk of developing ovarian carcinoma. Mutations in both BRCA1 and BRCA2 increase risk to ovarian carcinoma. While discussing the prognosis of this tumor, we divide ovarian tumor into two grades, that is low grade, that is well differentiated carcinoma, and high grade, which is moderately to poorly differentiated carcinoma. And the distinction can be made on the basis of nuclear atypia, which correlates with the patient survival. Some low-grade cancers, they arise in association with the borderline tumors. I repeat this thing, that some low-grade cancers, they arise in association with the borderline tumor, while most of the high-grade cancers or carcinomas, they appear to arise de novo without any recognizable precursor lesion. So most high-grade carcinomas, they appear to arise de novo without any precursor lesion. The low-grade tumors arising in serous borderline tumors have got mutation in the KRAS or BRAF oncogenes, or only rare mutations in P53. The high-grade tumors have a high frequency of mutations in P53 gene, but lack mutations in either KRAS or BRAF. Almost all reported cases of ovarian cancers arising in women with BRCA1 and BRCA2 mutation are high-grade serous carcinomas, and they also commonly have P53 mutation. Now, coming to the prognosis of these serous borderline and serous malignant tumors, borderline serous tumors may arise from or extend to the peritoneal surface as non-invasive implants. They remain localized and may cause no symptoms or slowly spread producing intestinal obstruction, and the complication may arise after many years. Low-grade carcinomas, which arise in borderline serous tumors, they are referred to as invasive implants because they show destructive behavior and infiltrative growth, which is similar to that of metastatic carcinoma. However, their progress is slow. High-grade tumors are often wildly metastatic throughout the abdomen at the time of presentation. The 5-year survival rate for borderline and malignant tumors confined within the ovarian mass ranges from 100% to 70% respectively, whereas 5-year survival rate for the same tumor involving the peritoneum is about 90% and 25% respectively.